All right, what it do? This your man King Eric the Media Assassin coming at y'all with another video. Subscribe, hit the like button for me. And this is an interesting breakdown of analysis that I want to do on Irv Gotti that a lot of people, if not hardly none, have done. Now, I'm going to break down how Irving Lorenzo became Irv Gotti. Going back to 1995 to 1997, this goes in parallel to what's been talked about in the Murder, Inc. doc. Now, you know Irv Gotti, he was always an ambitious guy. He was a more so humble producer. He produced for Jay, he produced for X, he produced for Jai, Mike Geronimo, you name it. And people would tell you he's probably a little more humble during those days. Like, he was more so himself. I remember when I bought the DMX Get At Me Dawg maxi single in 1998, and they had a B-side of Stop Being Greedy, where Irv Gotti was talking with DMX about the single. So, he started here talking about the single, and he sounded regular. He sounded like a regular guy. So, after producing for Jay, DMX, and soon to be Ja Rule, Russell Simmons awarded Irv Gotti with his own label. Because, you know, when you start hitting home runs like that, you brought Jay-Z and DMX to the equation and Def Jam, which led to them having one of their best years ever in business, they awarded Irv Gotti with his own label titled Murder, Inc. Records. And see, that the concept of Murder, Inc. was based off the Crime Family group, and he paralleled that with, instead of making contract hits like the Mob, they're going to do it on the Billboard charts. And the logo was inspired by that as well. It could also be said it was also inspired by Death Row, but that's another story. But he also knew that he had to have an identity. See, he had to find an identity in order to stand out, because it's a shark-driven business. The minute they smell blood, they're going to go in on you. And especially with now him being a head of a label, the headaches were going to be more so to bear. So he had to find an identity. When he was around Jay-Z and DMX doing that Rough Riders Hard Not Life tour, he studied Dame Dash. He studied how Dame would carry himself, from the way he would cuss out people, from the way he didn't take no shit from a lot of these people from Def Jam. He had to find a way to stand up to Lior Cole in that time, because Lior, he always had his eyes on these labels under him. So he learned a lot of that from Dame. And he learned that to where he handled his business like Dame in a little bit of ways. He knew he had to be a more obnoxious. He adopted that side of Dame. Who else did he study? He started studying Suge Knight. And they go back to working together, going back to almost 1995 almost. They was going to do some business together when Irv Gotti was going to get DMX on Death Row, but unfortunately that didn't happen, but they always kept a relationship, I guess. So, in March of that year, or April of 2000, I seen Murder, Inc. was featured on the Two Gangsta for Radio compilation. So they started doing business from there, and that went on for 2 to 3 years, where they were going to eventually consolidate and form a union. They did business with the Pledge joint, and they allowed him to use the Tupac sample for the Pledge. But also, Irv started taking pictures like Suge, you know, with the cigar, with the mafia look, kind of like how Death Row did it back in 1996 with the Godfather picture. You look on this, even on this thumbnail, it looked like something from Death Row. Tell me if I'm not lying. That looked like the whole Death Row background Godfather theme. So, then he also studied Puffy. Because think about it. He had to figure out a way how Puff did it. where he took a sound and commercialized it to where even the niggas couldn't even hate on it. So Irv Gotti basically studied the murder and studied the Bad Boy sound and tried to study Puff's formula and got his work ethic at that. Because no lie, Irv Gotti would work. He would work hard. If you look on that Murder, Inc. documentary, the guy worked hard. He went hard for his label. But somewhere along the way, he had to roll these personas of these people and become Irv Gotti. That's why DMX even said, "You're not Irv Gotti. You effing Irving Lorenzo. Gotti need to mind his effing business. You're Irving Lorenzo. Stop acting like you Gotti." Because around that time, he started really feeling himself. Especially on that murder, on the intro of the Murderers album, where he really tried to talk tough. That's when I knew it was the change. He really started talking real tough. You listen to the intro. Matter of fact, I'm going to play it a little bit. Hold on. I'm going to play it real fast. Hold on, right quick. I'm going to play a little bit. Here you go. He started talking tough.
It's that gangster shit right here, nigga. It's that shit that y'all niggas can't get with. Fuck all y'all industry clown ass niggas. Y'all can't get with this shit right here. This is murder, nigga. This shit ain't for you. This is for them niggas in the street. The niggas living that everyday fucking life. This shit is for them. This shit ain't for y'all industry ass niggas. Y'all niggas can eat a dick all fucking day, nigga. Y'all can't get with this. It's the INC, nigga. These bitch ass niggas, they be always them bitch ass niggas. The ones in the fucking mini percentile. Not the few, but the many. It's them niggas there. They come up here and say, "Gotti, Gotti, what you gonna do, Gotti? They shitting on y'all, Gotti. What you gonna do?" Like, I'm gonna tell y'all bitch ass what I'm gonna do. You ain't my nigga. My nigga ain't gonna ask me what I'm gonna do. He's gonna ride, nigga. He's gonna ride. The fuck's wrong with you? This shit ain't for you if you asking, nigga. We about this shit, nigga. We murder. Fuck y'all.
Now that's probably a mixture of cocaine, pills, and being high off fame. But that's how he became Irv Gotti. Irving Lorenzo became Irv Gotti. He studied the mannerisms of Dame Dash, P. Diddy, and Suge Knight and rolled all those personas into one. And this is what you get right now. And mix that with money. He got that $300 million deal. It's going to be worse now. Because now he learned what Suge was doing. Being real loose with the mouth and talking ish. Not caring who you're offending. He got that from Suge. So, yeah. That's what it is. So, let me know what you guys think in the comments, man. This is King Eric Holler.